Hi, I'm Sean Zalmanoff, here with another installment of the Lemons to Your Lemonade Show. Lemons to Your Lemonade is dedicated to helping you realtors make your closing sweet. Let's talk about the power of attorney today. Closing with the power of attorney is not complicated as long as we know about it well in advance. The biggest issue with power of attorneys is that the blanket power of attorney form is not acceptable in a real estate transaction. If a client just has something that says, Sally can sign for Jim, that doesn't work. The power of attorney form needs to be property specific. It needs to say, Sally can sign for Jim for the purchase of 123 Elm Street. Sometimes the power of attorney forms take a while to get back because people are out of town, on business, or traveling for other reasons. After all, if they were in town, we probably wouldn't need one. So as long as your lender knows about this a few weeks before the closing, it's easy to get it prepared and then turn a potential lemon into sweet, sweet lemonade. To hear more great tips, please subscribe for free on your right. If you found this information to be helpful, please share with others by forwarding, posting to Facebook or Twitter, and leave your comments below. Once again, I'm Sean Zalmanoff, and have a great day.